Morning students, today we are going to do one more topic for class 5th English, and that is homophones. What are homophones? These are the words that have same pronunciation, different spellings and different meaning. We can say that in our daily routine we use different words which have same pronunciation. For example, I can say C, S double E C S E A C. Both have same pronunciation, but their meaning is different. Their use is different. So that is called homophones. When spelling is different, when meaning is different, but pronunciation is the same. So in English, we must be very careful about the use of homophones. So one of the most important thing we must be aware while using, that which spelling or whose meaning is the most appropriate. For example, whole, actually whole, whole, whole. Both have same pronunciation, but they have different meaning. Actually whole, a hollow place in a surface. If I say he had a hole in his sock, means whatever he wears in his foot, he has a hole in that. W-H-O-L-E hole means completely. He has eaten the whole cake, means he has eaten the cake completely. Okay, the next one, we are having some of the homophones which are we have used in our sentences to know the difference between their meanings. First one is R-I-G-H-T, right. W-R-I-T-E, right. Right, you know R-I-G-H-T means correct. I say my father is always right. W-R-I-T-E, writing manner it is. So I write neatly. S-C-E, any scene, and the homophone word for it is S-E-E-N, scene. Both have different meaning but the same pronunciation. So I have used this in two different sentences. S-C-E, any scene means it is a beautiful scene. Whatever I am seeing, that is very beautiful. S-E-E-N, scene, it is the third form, past participle form of see. So I've used this in my perfect tense. I have seen a got. Next one is sun. S-U-N, sun, and S-O-N, sun. S-U-N, sun is a heavenly body and S-O-N, sun is a relation. S-U-N, sun, the sun gives us heat and light. Sun, my uncle has one son. S-O-N, sun. So don't get confused about the spelling. Just check out the meaning and use appropriate word at appropriate place. Don't go for the pronunciation only. Next one is T-A-I-L, tail. T-A-L-E, tail. Both have same pronunciation, but they are different in their meaning. T-A-I-L, tail, tail. It is the hind part of an animal. That's why I've used this. The elephant has a short tail. And the next one, T-A-L-E, tale. You told a tale, story, yesterday. Both of the words when have same pronunciation but different meaning and different spelling, that is called homophone. So I am giving you a homework. You have to use some of the homophones in your own sentences and try to make your own sentences. Try to find out the meaning of these and try to make sentences out of it. Ask if you have any query on WhatsApp. I'm always available there. I'm reading out these homophones for you and trying to explain also. First one, won. W-O-N. It is the second form of win. When you win something, O-N-E-1, it is your counting number. Second one, not. When you tie two things, not, not, negative form. New, K-N-E-W. It is the past form of no. And any new, fresh. Next one, R-I-G-H-T, right. Means correct. W-R-I-T-E, right. Writing manner. You did it. Next one, M-E-E-T, meet. Means get together. M-E-A-T means flesh of an animal. Next one, M-A-D-E, made. It is past form of make. M-A-I-D, it is the female servant that comes to help your mother at home. Next one, peace. P-E-A-C-E, silent situation, silent manner when someone works in silently. P-I-E-C-E, it is a part of something. Next one, see. I explained it to you. See, when you look something, see something, that is see. S-E-A-C, it is a expansion of salty water. Next, tail, T-A-I-L, T-A-L-E, you did it. I told it to you as an example. Next one, weak, W-E-A-K, weak, W-E-E-K, weak. First week means not too much strong. And next week is having 7 days. Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday and Saturday. And then Sunday. That's your holiday. Next one. Steal and steal. S-T-E-A-L, steal means getting something without the permission of someone. Bina kisse puche kuch le lena. S-T-E-E-L, steel. It is a type of material from which you have made your utensils. You got utensils of steel. Next one. M-A-I-L, mail. It is letter form which you get through post office. M-A-L-E, mail. It is used for masculine gender. I-D-L-E, idol. Lazy. I-D-O-L, idol. It is the image of God which you worship. Two and two. T-O-O-2 means more than enough. And next one, T-W-O, counting number. Try to use these in your own sentences. If you have any query, any doubt, ask me. And in your next video, I will take a short test of your homophones and your earlier topic which you did. See you soon. Take care. Bye-bye.